Peter, what happened? I remember a battle. It didn't go so well. That explains the bandages. Both healers? Oh my. Well, I remember the goblins. And the hobs. Yes, there was a cave troll as well. But then everything... I think there was an explosion or two. Did everyone get away okay? Mm-hmm. That's good. That's my job as a crusader, you know. Take all the hits, so no one else has to. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to scare you, leader. I normally know my own limits. I knew I could normally handle that many at once. But they just kept coming, beating on me, trying to get to my lovely party members. I just had to protect everyone, even if I had to put my own life on the line, you know? That's how important you all are to me. Especially you, leader. Well, yes, for a while now, actually. The way you fight alongside the others. The way you back me up when things look grim. It feels like I had half a dozen arrows in my side. I did? And a spear? Two swords? Oh. Make it sound like I was used more as a pincushion than as a crusader. Both healers said the same thing. And the priestess passed out from exhaustion. It's a good thing the cleric has so much stamina then. Plus, I have you to watch over me, don't I, leader? But are you sure you're okay, just sitting next to me? It's a cold night, and though the campfire is warm, even I can feel the chill of the night here in my bedroll. I'm sure I do look pale from the sound of it. I've lost quite a bit of blood. I might need help keeping warm. Soup? That might help too, but I'm not sure I could keep it down right now, if I'm honest. Although, sometimes I just want to be safe in someone else's arms. I mean, I admit that I feel most at ease on the field of battle with my sword, getting beaten on and protecting everyone, but sometimes I just want to curl up and snuggle too, especially after nearly dying. I just want to feel your warmth, leader. You know, you may not think of me that way, but I'm still a woman. You will? Thank you, leader. I understand. It's only because of my circumstances. Thank you. There we go. So warm. I didn't know just how cold I really was until just now. I feel so weak in your arms. Is that from all the damage I took? The injuries? Or is it... could it be... something more? Yes, I guess I did take quite the beating. But it was all for my precious friends. I couldn't let them get hurt, how could I? And I wasn't about to let anything hit you. You think I'm too overprotective? But that's literally my job. I'm not good at real fighting like you. I can't cast spells. I can't heal. I'm best at protecting people. I'm your shield. And I enjoy keeping everyone safe from harm. I enjoy... taking all that punishment that our enemies throw at us. That's what all my stamina is for, you know. Okay. If you insist, I'll try to be more careful, leader. But only if you'll accept a confession. A confession of my heart. Here it is. Ever since I met you at the guild, well, I've admired you. You're so confident and strong, and I'm just not. And the longer I watched you and traveled with you, I came to realize something. I really admire that in you. Those are the qualities that I lack and hope to achieve one day. Maybe. Just maybe, if I can stay with you long enough, those traits could rub off, or I could learn to be like you. Or at least, that was my original thinking. Over time, as my feelings for you grew, I realized it was something more than just admiration and respect. It took me a while, since I had never felt these things before. I mean, I felt similar feelings in the heat of battle, but this is different. This feels... sure. What I'm trying to say is, well, I've fallen in love with you, leader. What? You too? How long? since our first adventure, and you never said anything. I'm so embarrassed now. You should have said something. Though, I do suppose, with the distance I've kept as your shield and your policies on relationships in the party, it would have been hard to say much of anything. But now that we've both shared our feelings for one another, perhaps snuggling in the same bedroll is okay? I mean, I know we should avoid relationships within the party, but leader, I don't care. I'm still going to protect everyone just the same. And well, I know you're still going to be a great leader. A little snuggling is okay. If anyone asks, you can call it part of my healing. To help with the blow to my psyche. Nearly dying for my friends would naturally leave me mentally scarred. No one knows how emotionally weak I am right now, after all. Right now, I need your support. Now, more than ever. I feel so weak and completely drained. I've never felt like this before. It's almost scary how vulnerable I am right now. I don't think I could sit up if I had to, let alone raise my sword. You could really take advantage of me right now. If you wanted. Leader? I really am a little scared. This isn't a joke. I can't lift my head. I've never been this helpless before. Never been this close to death. I've never been this beaten up. Never anywhere near this bad. Please, hold me tighter. I did a good job, didn't I? Everyone got away safely because of me, didn't they? Goodness. I worry about everyone so very much. It's just, if even one injury were to befall one of our friends because of me, I don't think I could handle it right now. As weak as I am right now, I don't think I could have handled knowing I let anyone get hurt. It would just be too much to bear. Me? I'm sure I'll be okay after some rest and recovery, right? I just need some time with you, and yes, I'll be more careful in the future. I promise, my love. Oops. I mean, later. Are you sure? Just while we're alone? I think you're just trying to make me blush, aren't you? Now that I'm so helpless. You're the one that has to defend me now, aren't you, my love? This is a strange feeling for me. I have to rely on someone else for protection. But if it's you, then I think I wouldn't mind being protected. Or taken advantage of. Yes, I think I'll be okay for now. As long as I have you here to stay by my side for a while, my love. Thank you.